Hello children, as I have said you, in the next class we are going to see the trigonometric first exercise. So are you ready with your textbooks? Open the textbooks. Already I have written 6 problems on the board, right? Solutions will be in front of you within 5 minutes with my calculations, right? And 2 more problems are there that we'll see after this 6. So textbooks are open, no trigonometry, it is not a joke, right? So first question, what it is? A triangle, you have ABC and the sides of 3 sides are given to you, and find out sine A, cos A and tan A. So first of all, draw a right angle triangle. So AB, now this will be AC. Why? Because highest side will be always greater than the other 2 sides, then this will be the left out AB. Now AB is equal to 8 centimeters and BC is equal to 15 centimeters. So we are standing at A. So here is your angle. So sine A is nothing but opposite by hypotenuse. Now cos A is nothing but adjacent by hypotenuse. Now tan A is equal to opposite by adjacent, that is 15 by 8. So simple. In the same way, here you have in the second problem triangle PQR. So angle P is here. Why? Because 90 degrees given to you. PQR. PQ is 7, QR is 25 and PR is 24. In your textbook, 24 is not given to you. So you have to find out 24. How to find out? 7 square plus x square is equal to 25. Right? 25 square. So 7 7s are 49 plus x square is equal to 625. So x is equal to 625 minus 49, that is the square root. Then x you will get square root of, so here you will get 576, that is equal to 24. So now you got all the 3 sides. Now tan q, so you are standing here, tan q is 24 by 7 minus tan r. So here you are standing, tan r will be 7 by 24, right? So here if you take LCM, you will get 169. So 24 times 24 square minus 7 square, right? So again 24 is 576 minus 49 by 169. So 576 minus 49, how much you will get? So here you will get 527 by 160. Sorry children, here 7 into 24 LCM is 168. So here you will get 168. So 168. So 527 by 168 your answer. Got it? Is it clear here? The same concept you have to use in the third problem. So in triangle ABC, angle B is 90 degrees. Now where are this A, B, C? So this will be your A and C. So the opposite sides will be taking as small sides. So for A opposite, this will be 24. For B opposite, this will be 25. And C opposite, this C we don't know. From the previous problem, just we can go as C is equal to 7. Now if you do the Pythagoras theorem also, you will get the same thing. Right? So how to write here? 24 square plus x square is equal to 25. That implies 25 square. So x is equal to square root of 625 minus 576. So you will get 49, that is equal to 7. So what is asking? You are standing at this angle BAC. So angle BAC, so you are standing here. So what is asking? So he is asking cos theta and tan theta. So cos theta what? You are standing here means this is 7. 7 by 25. Now tan, if you are standing here opposite by adjacent, that is 24 by 7. Got it, children? So all problems are like that only. Now here this is little different. So 3 tan A, see, I have said tan is not having any meaning if angle is not there. But 3, it is not an angle. 3 into tan A is equal to 4. So tan A is equal to 4 by 3. Right? So now take down the triangle. So take it as A, B, C. Right? So you are standing here tan. Tan means opposite by adjacent. So this is 4 by 3. Find out hypotenuse. So 3 square plus 4 square is equal to 3 square is 9, 4 4 is 16, that is equal to root of 25, that is 5, that is nothing but AC. So this is your 5 centimeters. Now you got all 3 sides. Now standing here sine A. So sine A is equal to 4 by 5, opposite by adjacent, hypotenuse. Now cos A is adjacent by hypotenuse. Right? Clear? Now coming to the, so this I have did for fifth problem. Now fourth problem. So fourth problem here. So take always down as A, then it will become easy. So cos is adjacent by hypotenuse. You have to find out this. So how to find out? Same story. So 12 square plus x square is equal to 13 square. So x square is equal to 169 minus 144. So 9 minus 4 is 5. 4, 5, 6. So x 25, that is 5. So this side is 5. Okay. So now sine A. Sine A standing opposite by hypotenuse. Now tan A. Tan A is opposite by adjacent, that is 5 by 13. Got? So fourth one finished, fifth one also finished, sixth one is little different. Cos A is equal to cos X. So first of all, you draw a triangle X, right? A, B. Right? Now he is asking angle A is equal to angle X. First of all, he said cos A is equal to cos X. So if you are standing at A, right, if you are standing at A, formula is adjacent by hypotenuse. So cos A will be AB by AX, adjacent by hypotenuse. Now if you are talking about X, so you are standing here. So adjacent by AX. So AX got cancelled. AB is equal to BX. So these two sides are equal. Right? So this is 90 degrees. And AC is hypotenuse. So just by seeing this as these two sides are equal and the angles are acute. So here you can say clearly angle A is equal to angle S. So hence proved. Got it, children? Is it clear? And last two problems left out, we will see those also. The seventh problem and eighth problem we will see now. Here cot theta is equal to 7 by 8. So draw a triangle. So stand, make it as theta. Cot is the ratio of adjacent by opposite. Got it? 7, 8. Now take it as ABC, find out this side. So this side AC is equal to root of 7 square plus 8 square. So 7 7s are 49, 8 8s are 64. So it is 9 plus 4 is 13, 10 plus 1 is 11. So this is root 113. Fine. So you got now 3 sides. Now find out this. Now is it not looking like A plus B into A minus B? And A plus B into A minus B. So A square minus B square by a square minus b square. So 1 minus, now sine theta, you are standing here, sine means 8 by root 1 13 whole square by 1 minus 7 by root 1 13 whole square. So that is equal to 64 by 1 13. So 1 minus 49 by 1 13. So take the LCM. So 1 13 minus 64 by 1 30. 113 by 113 minus 49 by 113. So 113 got cancelled. So this is 49 by 64. Right? So what is the answer? 49 by 64. Now, in the same way, find out this also. So 1 plus sine. Sine is nothing but 8 by root 113. Now cos is 7 by root 113. So root 113 plus 8 by root 113. LCM I am taking 7 by root 113. 113 got cancelled. So root 113 plus 8 by 7. So here next problem is tan A is equal to root 3. So draw a triangle. So make it as angle A, B, C. So tan is opposite by adjacent. So opposite is root 3. Nothing is there means 1. Right? Denominator you have to take it as 1. Now find out AC. Now AC how can you find out? 1 square plus root 3 whole square. So root of, that is AC. So 1 plus 3, that is equal to root 4. So 2 is the AC. Got it? Now sine A, so standing here, sine A is root 3 by 2 into cos C, root 3 by 2 again, root 3 by 2 plus cos A, sorry, here A angle, cos A 1 by 2 into sine, again 1 by 2. So here root 3 into root 3, 3 by 4 plus 1 by 2, 2 is a 4. So 3 plus 1 by 4, when I take the LCM, 4 by 4, that is equal to 1. Right? From the same triangle, you have to solve this also. Now cos A. Cos A is 1 by 2 into cos C. Root 3 by 2 minus sine A. So root 3 by 2 sine C 1 by 2. So this is root 3 by 4 minus root 3 by 4. Root 3 by 4, root 3 by 4, that is equal to 0. Right, children? So how much time it took to calculate the problems? Very less time. So if you understand the concept proper way, angles, sides, taking, right, if you are doing very frequently and doing more of practice, these problems can be done in within 10 to 15 minutes. Whole exercise we have finished. Right, children? So remaining things we will see in the next part of the class. Once again, I am saying practice the things more, remember the formulas. In the next part, we are going to find out the angles. So it is very important, children. So don't be take lenience to solve these problems. Do more practice. So we'll meet in the next part of the class. Thank you.